But first, it is a new year and a new legislative session at the State House. Priorities on both sides of the aisle include putting Mainers back to work. The House and Senate will take up business left unfinished during the opening round of the 125th legislature last year. Energy, education, and voting rights are among the issues on the table, but the budget will be center stage in the opening weeks, at issue balancing the state budget by closing a $200 million shortfall in the Medicaid program. And that tops our project economy coverage tonight. News 8's Megan Torgerson is live at Augusta with more. Megan?
Hi, Tracy. Yeah, history was made here today with a swearing-in ceremony. Other than that, it was a relatively quiet day. The House and Senate adjourned around noon to come back tomorrow. The governor says he has a lot he wants to accomplish this session. The first day of the legislative session marked a first in history. This morning, the governor swore in the state's only Maliseet Indian legislator.
This is a good thing. It's a good thing for the state. It's a good thing for our tribe. And I'm really humbled and honored to represent the people.
It wasn't all about firsts at the State House, though. Frustrated Mainers brought up a familiar issue, the troubled state of the economy.
We've collected nearly 1,000 postcards and messages for the governor.
The governor says the economy is his focus this legislative session. Others include education and energy independence. LePage says that can be accomplished through a natural gas pipeline and heating homes with electricity.
If we do not succeed in lowering energy costs, we have no future in Maine.
LePage says the economic well-being of the state also rests on revamping Maine care, an issue that's been on the table for a while. His budget proposal seeks to cut $60 million from funding for private non-medical housing for the elderly. Both Republican and Democratic legislators say they will reject those cuts. The governor says that's a problem.
Housing is not part of Medicaid. The issue that we have right now is a housing issue and a Medicaid issue. If you separate out the housing issue and you solve that, then you don't have a problem with Medicaid.
But Democratic House Leader Emily Kane says more needs to be done before an agreement on Maine care and with the governor is reached.
When really what we need is a level-headed approach to improving the way Maine care is delivered in the state of Maine, not one that's based on a manufactured crisis.
Yeah, on a legislative front, some of those top priorities include closing the state's budget gap and those Maine care cuts. However, on a personal level, the governor says he will continue to fight domestic violence this legislative session. We're live in Augusta. Megan Torgerson, News 8.